which I mean was problematic. You hear stories about people voting and saying, I want to repeal Obamacare, but meanwhile they're in the state exchange. So and I think you know that there's a lot of political reasons behind that why the opposition to the ACA started this campaign. But
do you feel that that was a large number of people? I mean, I know that that's something that I heard on the news, but as someone who's not in the healthcare industry, you know, is that something that politicians or news stations maybe wanted to play up? Or do you see that as a real problem?
I mean, I'm working from anecdotal evidence.
Yeah.
They might have better experiences, but I mean, it's a real issue that people really face.
Wow.
Yeah, I can't cite the exact percentage, but there's research that, you pull the research, that shows that people, when you ask them about the aspects of the Affordable Care Act, you like the fact that people up to the age of 26 can stay on their parents' insurance? Do you like that there's not pre-existing conditions? Do you like the expansion of Medicaid? They like all of that, and then if you ask them, do you like the Affordable Care Act? Do you like Obamacare? They say, no, I don't like that at all. But so they don't really understand that they don't understand what the act actually provides and what it covers. It's so a lot of misunderstanding.
I think one of the biggest things that people got hung up with throughout the whole process of the Affordable Care Act was that there is a penalty fee for not signing up for insurance. And that seemed to be, I feel like, one of the biggest hang-ups because people were saying, well, this is against my liberties as a free American, and I should have the right to choose whether I'm going to get health insurance, when really what we need to be doing is looking more at the big picture and realizing that when we have this huge group of people being insured, it drives costs down, ultimately. Because everybody's covered. It's a bigger risk group. Whenever there's a bigger risk group, the cost will go down. And I feel like, but that just that instance of there being a possibility that you may not have a choice about having health insurance was just like the major hang up. And I still have patients who would not be having care if it weren't for the Affordable Care Act, who still are upset about Obamacare, even though it's helping them, and obviously they're receiving benefits from it.
Great.
Yeah. In terms of things that people kind of aren't even aware of, and that I think that I just sort of, to do it my homework, was printed out the kind of Kaiser summary of this and was refreshing myself about it. And it runs to like 14 pages of like 0.6 font. And you kind of go through it, and I think one of the things that Will and I were talking about just before we got started was how much is in here with respect to kind of data gathering and trying to do some quality improvements. Because if you want to reduce healthcare costs, you can kind of do it two ways. One, you can pay people less or just have less care, but the other way is to deliver care kind of more effectively and do things that we're kind of talking about. You know, can you have someone come in and treat the infection in their foot before their whole foot is rotting? I mean, can you do stuff early? And there's a lot in the ACA about trying to set up sort of systems to deliver care more smartly, to give care kind of more systematically, and make sure that kind of when you go to a hospital stay, whether you go to one in Milwaukee or Cincinnati or somewhere else, you're going to get the same kind of bare minimum level of care at least, and you're not going to kind of have all this heterogeneity and that everybody's going to be getting a better experience. And so I think that I'm certainly not aware of all of the things in there and all these moving parts, but there's a lot kind of behind the scenes to try and make the whole healthcare system work better that is outside of the kind of the purview of the individual healthcare consumer, which I think is hopefully would be stuff that would remain even if we kind of changed all of the mechanics in terms of insurance and other stuff, but we would see. But it's stuff that I think is the most exciting and the stuff that in 10 or 20 years will have the biggest impact actually on healthcare.
Which I think is what most people don't realize is because healthcare is such a complex issue, you know, even people who work with it every day have to like go to the Kaiser Foundation to look it up, but people don't realize that even if they're not, you know, getting insurance through a state exchange, the ACA included things that affect all of our healthcare. Mm-hmm. And so people, especially obviously upper middle class people, didn't think about that, didn't realize that it didn't connect those two.
Right. Can you explain what you were talking about real fast?
Sure. So sort of some of, I think, the best data out there, and if you want to, you hear on the news, it was like, you know, healthcare premium rates went up by 75% or went down by 10%. Sort of one of the biggest clearinghouses for data is the Kaiser Family Foundation. I don't actually know what he did, but he was presumably some incredibly rich guy who set up this foundation, and they do a lot of kind of this healthcare policy work and healthcare data collection. And one of the things that they publish, I think, every year, which I think is really great, is how the rates actually change for like a 40-year-old consumer buying kind of a silver care plan, just kind of in the middle. And kind of giving those average numbers and sort of what they said, you know, in 2015 to 16, premiums went up by about 3% and they went up by about 9% between 16 and 17, which is high, but it's much less than kind of what we were getting on the news and people talking about, you know, your premiums would go up by 70% under Obamacare and a lot of this inflammatory stuff. So if you just kind of Google Kaiser Foundation and kind of ACA stuff, you can find a lot of stuff out there about the nuts and bolts of how the system works.
Cool, thank you. To our next question.